गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी टेक न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज कोऑर्डिनेशन केमिस्ट्री, कोऑर्डिनेशन कंपाउंड्स, और यू कैन से इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज कॉम्प्लेक्स कंपाउंड्स। कंपाउंड्स आर ऑफ यूजुअली थ्री टाइप, सिंपल कंपाउंड, डबल एज वेल एज कंप्लेक्स। इफ आई टेक NaCl, CaCl2, AlCl3, these are known as simple salt, right? But if I say KCl, MgCl2, and 6' water, this is known as carnallite, like it is a double salt. But if I say K4, FeCn whole 6, now this is known as complex salt or complex compound. So the question is very important: what is complex compound? Those compounds in which central metal atom is taken from the d block elements associated with the ligands, called as complex compound. And any compound is said to be complex, they must be associated with a square bracket. It is what the identification of the complex compound, or the bond which is formed in between metal and the ligand by the coordinate bond or dative bond. So it is known as coordination compounds or the complex compound. So we take first is, if I take for example a structure of complex compound, I take K4, FeCn whole 6, so the ionizable part outside of the square bracket is known as ionizable part, or this is known as what ion? This is known as counter ion. Rest of the part which is covered within the square bracket is called as non-ionizable part, or it is known as coordination sphere or coordination entity or complex entity. Now this is known as iron act as a central metal atom or ion. These are usually taken from d block elements: copper, chromium, nickel, manganese, palladium, platinum, gold, silver, etc. And the parts which is linked with the central metal atom is known as, what is that? Ligands. I discussed the ligand at the right time, and total number of ligands is known as coordination number, that is equal to 6. If I give you the other example, CONS3 whole 5, bromine and SO4. The ionizable part is outside of the square bracket, is called as ionizable part, or this is known as counter ion. And this, the whole part under the square bracket, is known as non-ionizable part. Cobalt is a central metal atom or ion, and these two, ammonia and bromine, known as here ligands, and total number of ligands, 5 ammonia or 1 bromine, so the coordination number is equal to again 6. So coordination number is either 4 or 6. There are two possibilities. If I say NiH2O whole 4 and 2 positive, so here there is no any ionizable part. Nickel and water in the square bracket, that is why it is known as central metal atom, and that is known as ligands, and total number of ligands called as coordination number 4. So the way you can identify what is ligand, what is coordination number, what is central metal atom, and ligands. So Next part is the, you can see, types of complex compound. First is the, you can say, anionic complex. Anionic complex means the negatively charged complex. Not necessarily charged, visible or may not be visible. If I say CrH2O whole 4 or 2 negative, here charge is very much visible. So that shows it is an anionic complex. But if I say K4FeCN whole 6, how can you say it is an anionic complex? Because of once you ionize this part, potassium, 1 potassium 4 positive, this is the 4 negative, FeCN whole 6. So the way it is an anionic complex, because of with respect to one other can be identified. K4FeCN whole 6 going to a split, then it forms complex is anionic and ionizable part is cationic. Second is the what part? Cationic complex. If charge is visible, if I say manganese H2O whole 4 and 2 positive. So here there is no question over the type of the complex because charge is very much visible. So you can say, sir, it is a complex, positively charged complex. That's all right. But if I say CO, NH3 whole 5, bromine and SO4. Now tell me, how can you say it is a complex compound? Complex part. Now sulfate, once you're going to break this, SO4 carrying 2 unit negative charge plus, and this is 2 unit positive charge, CO, NH3 whole 5 and bromine. So here the charge is positive, the way you can say cationic complex. And the third one is neither cationic nor anionic, it is non-ionic complex. That is, I mean, neutral complex. So the third one is the neutral complex. That complex is, if I say Zn carbonyl 4 times, there is no any positive or negative charge. It is very much clear it is a neutral complex. Ni cyanide whole 6, no any charge. This kind of complex is called as neutral complex. So complex compounds are of three types: cationic, anionic, as well as neutral. Then the difference between double salt and what compound? That is the complex compound. Double salt on ionization in aqueous solution to give simple salt like KCl MgCl2 0.6 times water. Once it is dissociated, KCl separated, MgCl2 separated, they are converted into the simpler salt. Like it is known as carnallite. Now next is the Mohr salt. Mohr salt is FeSO4 NH4 whole 2 SO4 0.6 times water. Now going to break ferrous sulfate plus ammonium 1 unit positive charge and sulfate 2 unit negative charge. The way you can say it is the Mohr salt. And next will be the potash alum. What is the potash alum? Phytkari in Hindi. It is called Phytkari in Hindi, antiseptic. K2SO4, Al2SO4, whole thrice 0.24 times water. Now if it is going to break, potassium sulfate out, aluminium sulfate out, and water is lost. So the way you can say that all the double salts on ionization to form simpler salt. But come to this side. So there are three, you remember, carnallite, Mohr salt as well as potash alum. These are the double salt. Now dear students, here complex compounds are not completely dissociated into simpler salt like K4FeCN6. If they undergo dissociation, then positive potassium 4 times, but this iron and cyanide not going to be dissociated at any cost. So this is the identity of the complex compound. The parts in the within the square bracket are not ionized into anything else. Now, second point of difference is the, you can see double salt exists in solid or in aqueous state, but complex compounds usually exist in the what state? Solid state. Now, double salt contains only what compound? Ionic bond. But they contain not only ionic plus what bond? Coordinate bond, or you can say it is the dative bond. Now the fourth is the double salt on ionization do not retain their previous property. Why? Complex compound will retain their previous property. So these are the differences between double salt as well as complex compounds.